I'm in Phong Nha right now, and I arrived yesterday night, and today we are going on the Echo Trail, and then after that we might check out some caves, because Phong Nha is mostly famous for its caves. The drive here was absolutely beautiful. This is what I imagined Vietnam to be. I'm going to show you in the videos after this, but it's so beautiful. Look at that. We are now visiting the famous cave in Phong Nha called Paradise Cave, and they just discovered it 10 years ago, and it's supposed to be the biggest cave in Vietnam, I think, and the biggest cave in the world. It's pretty impressive. It's 250 to get in, 250 dong, which is like
250,000 euros.
Yeah, 250,000, so it's like 10 euros. My nice group here. Yo people, he's also a vlogger.
Hello. The Travel Joe.
Travel Joe. If you speak French, he has beautiful French vlogs.
It's just videos.
Some of them are just been... Exactly. So you should just check it out. I can put the links down below. Made it to the cave, and it's like actually quite a hike up here. Not a hike, like there's a path, but it goes around and around, and it goes for quite a while. So I understand why it was only discovered 10 years ago, because otherwise, like before the path was here, you would have to go like vertical, I guess, and why would you just randomly go to a mountain if you don't want to go trekking there or something like that? And there's so many mountains around here, so I guess, you know, you don't see every single spot of it. It's a Christmas tree, guys. There we go, a castle. Okay, we found some stairs. We found a gate. Perfect, let's go. Don't do this at home, kids.
Double vlogging mode. Holy shit, that's intense.
Now it's real exploring here, guys. This is batshit.
Okay, ready? I'm going that some of them can this is attack you.
So nah. Much batshit. This is like a glacier, so there's like holes in the mud, and you know, you don't know, when you step down, you might fall.
You have huge spotlights and someone is like, what are you doing here?
There was no sign, don't go here.
No.
So we're actually not doing anything bad. We have now walked like 500 meters into the cave. Pretty deep. Pretty scary. It is so awesome though. This is what I live for. We are now eating the last food we have.
I'm hungry. Candy! I'm
Here we can just walk because the cave is so freaking huge. So it's like 50 meters up to the top, which is pretty awesome. And we are back to civilization. Or not really civilization, but we made it out of the cave. The lights are still on because it's quite late, so we were thinking maybe they were gonna close the cave soon, which wouldn't be so funny. How high it is. Today we wanted to go to caves, but it was a bit expensive. So we took a shortcut. This is where we are. I don't know if it's a shortcut. Where are we?
We're at the end of our road.
I know where we are, in the middle of fucking nowhere.
The middle of fucking nowhere.
It's a dead end.
We were considering driving through the river, but meh.
If it was a rental scooter, I would do it.
Out of fuel?
Yeah, we ran out of fuel, so now we're so lucky.
That's how you fix it. So we decided we're gonna go have a look around with the motos and find a place to go swimming. It's really hard actually to find a place to go swimming here. So we went to the Botanical Gardens and you can go swimming there. You have to pay 40,000, but it's alright. It's like less than 2 euros. Here we are swimming. The water is really nice, crystal clear. We just stopped to take some pictures and this guy with his buffaloes, he asked me if I want to take a picture of him and then we all took a selfie of him. All my dreams are just some fragile things, they're paper wings, and I don't think they'll carry my weight, cause I've been falling for days to the sea, yeah. Try to breathe, but I've been drowning in waves of jealousy, and anyone could see that I'm lost. Through the seas I've been tossed, and I'm not free, I'm not free, yeah. So I open my eyes and I fall
sky while the day turns to night. Are you coming for my love? Flown too close to the sun, falling like a crush. Now the damage is done. I have been for my love.
Baby driving lessons, right? This is before she goes on the big roads, which is in like 4 years or something. I mean, I seen kids drive scooters here, it's crazy. So guys, today we decided to go on an adventure. So we decided to wake up 6 in the morning to drive out really far. Exactly today, it's also raining. We're still doing it. We're ready. Yeah. Stuff nicely packed. Shout out to Claire for the bag. Thanks a lot. It's been so helpful. Other stuff. It's nice. It's about 20 degrees for me right now. It's like freezing cold. It's like winter. It's basically, it's winter.
Because I can't bear the weight, and I guess I'm afraid of going down, going down.
Guess what, guys? His motor is broken. It doesn't turn on.
Down, and you're a race, a silhouette of me, and I won't leave a trace. I know I know how far I can fall till there's nothing at all but your face.
So we are in the middle of the national park, kind of in the middle of nowhere, and his engine does not start. But there's no people going by. Adventures. You know, the things that happened to me on this trip. Hashtag. Update. So we found out what the problem was, and yeah, we were trying to fix it. We couldn't fix it. We thought we were gonna have to go with parkour and build the motorbikes, but then a car came by and we like stopped it, and the guy just jumped out. He looked on the scooter. We kind of showed him what we thought the problem was, and he was like, yeah. He started fixing it, and now it's fixed. The people here are amazingly good at the scooters.
So I open my eyes and I fall through the sky while the day turns to night. I open for my love.
The hostel, because the woman was there, is we are trying to go to Son Doong cave, and it is actually it's if you want to go there you have to go with a tour, and there's only one organization that organizes it, and it costs $3,000. So $3,000 to go to this cave. Yeah, so we decided we want to go there on our own. This was actually, we decided it before we knew it's $3,000 to go there. We were just like, oh yeah, this cave looks cool. Now, ever since yesterday, when we told the girl at our hostel, and she got really scared that we want to go there, because her brother is a police, and she's like, you're gonna get arrested for this. So we drove now to this river, because this is not the official way to go to the cave. It is 4 kilometers out in the jungle there. And we want to try to get there right now. And that's the plan.
Yeah, I just tried to climb down from over there, but the soil is really loose and the stones aren't really, you can't get a good grip on them, so quite dangerous. And at one point I had to kind of stand there. I was standing on 2 stones that were kind of loose and I had nothing to hold on to, so it was quite risky.
And it's steep, isn't it?
Yeah, it's very steep.
Over there.
What a good idea.
Yeah.
Not a good idea.
And we're standing at this edge and we can't go down there. And I think we're gonna have to cancel our mission.
Yeah, probably.
It's not funny. It's nothing to laugh about. We're like actually really sad. Because we really wanted to do this. But yeah, this one is really slippery. So we can't go down there. We tried. But yeah. We have a sad story. We didn't go to the Son Doong cave. Because, yeah, we couldn't go there. The path we found wasn't walkable, and then the path that is the official path, there were people there, like there was a guard kind of, so we couldn't go. But now we found this nice jungle track. There's monkeys, you know, I love monkeys. See that cut up wood? I'm pretty sure that's illegal. Pretty sure. This has been my hostel the last days. Here's the lovely dorm. That's where I slept. And that's where I slept. It has a hot shower, nice bathroom, really good breakfast. And I can really recommend it. The staff is super nice. It's not a hostel, it's a homestay. And it is cold, I will tell you very soon. I keep forgetting the name because it's hard. That's the homestay. If you're in Phong Nha, definitely stay here. It is also the cheapest one. So what meal of the day is this?